Ford has made some major business decisions based on electric vehicles. But these steps they take can actually bankrupt them much sooner than before, and Ford could face serious problems. Yes, you heard it right. If you want to know more about Ford in the face of bankruptcy, stay with us until the video's end. Obviously, the legacy company is an outsider when it comes to electronic vehicles. The level of sales they make is not high and gradually decreases from month to month. Let's compare the sales Tesla and Ford are making and see which company is worth an investment. Tesla has provided us with consistency on sales, so why settle for less? In order for Ford to have its best chance in electric vehicles, they have to put in all their best resources, but still have not succeeded. However, in the face of declining sales, they are not giving up. Instead, they're going to launch their F-150 pickup truck. Ford wants to prove that it can offer what Tesla can offer as well, but they still fail to do so. Even less, they do not have an economist scale to make them beautiful and functional, and they don't have the resources to make the transition and reduce production costs. Although they have this excellent tax advantage to incentivize their new production of EVs, nevertheless, Tesla could be 10,000 times cheaper. Ford is seriously ill-constrained. The launch of the F-150 has been delayed, and it will take a long time for Ford to launch more models of electric vehicles. If they rush, very few people will buy it. Tesla has set the bar so high that other companies choose to drop out because you can never put a good man down. GM and Ford lost $24.1 billion last quarter. GM last posted an annual profit in 2004, while Ford has not made an annual profit since 2005. Rashid Merriam, a spokeswoman for GM, said the company still expects to add $15 billion in cash by the end of next year. GM's turnaround could be achieved outside of bankruptcy with its $15 billion savings program and potential electric car, said Martin Bienenstock, president of business solutions at New York law firm Dewey & Beef. The benefits of bankruptcy could include converting large unsecured bond debt into stock and rejecting and renegotiating dealership agreements to foster a more efficient brand mix, Bienenstock said. Ford has a cash cushion, spokesman Mark Truby said yesterday in response to the S&P report citing the prospects of further downgrading. We were fortunate to go to the markets at the right time, Mr. Truby said, referring to the US $23. He said, Ford is reviewing its liquidity and will provide an update when it releases third quarter financial results. Ford has not yet given a date for the release, which the company typically releases later in October. Chrysler has no plans to declare bankruptcy, spokeswoman Sean Morgan said. Automakers got congressional approval last month to fund $25 billion in low-interest loans to help develop more fuel-efficient cars. The funds will be split primarily between Ford, GM, and Chrysler based in Auburn Hills, Michigan. Although other automakers such as Volkswagen AG have said they will seek a part. Regulators are writing the rules for this loan even as automakers' conditions worsen. Industry researcher J.D. Powers & Associates estimated Thursday that sales across the US industry would fall to 13.6 million this year, and last year's total was 16.1 million. Bankruptcy is not an option for Ford Motor Co., CEO William Clay Ford said. The company's restructuring plan is on the line set in January and moving forward, Ford said on April 5th, accepting the Automobile Industry Action Group Award as Automotive Industry Manager of the Year. If you've gotten this far, be sure to smash the subscribe button for more awesome content. Called The Way Ahead, the plan calls to eliminate 30,000 jobs and the closure of 14 factories, Ford said. The Way Forward plan is a pretty powerful remedy. Cutting costs alone is not going to save us. Gradual change is not going to help. Ford said he was focusing on building a new organization that was more agile and less bureaucratic and better able to respond to changes in the market. The automaker no longer had the luxury of relying on multi-year cycle plans, he said. The first thing we need to do is put honesty on the table. The honesty of our competitive position, the strength or lack of our products, the strength or lack of our processes, and really deal with the issues. With each other genuine honesty, Ford mentioned. The number two American automaker, Ford, on April 3rd, reported a 4.6% decline in vehicle sales in the United States in March, compared to a year ago when cumulative volumes were lower. Ford also noted that only a portion of Ford's business, its North American auto business, is not profitable. "We have a big problem that is the American auto industry, and we were going to solve this problem, and when we solve that, this discussion will go away," he added. Ford said US government policy that addressed healthcare, pensions, security, and sources of future energy supplies would also help domestic automakers. "We compete every day with companies that have different levels of government support," he said. You may enjoy this video here. Until next time, thank you for watching.